You may have looked at this course on the Pluralsight website and went, wow, this seems like a real short course for cryptography. Well, it isn't. We're just going to do things a little bit different. In fact, I think you're going to find that this is going to prove even better. Now, let me just start off by saying that if you are planning on taking the CEH, the Certified Ethical Hacker exam, and there's a list of topics for cryptography, I have a way for you to cover all of those topics. But if you do it the way that I'm going to show you, you'll also get even more information that'll help you understand it a little bit better. This is a beginner's guide to cryptography, kind of like Cryptography 101, but in the materials I'm going to give you, it's going to take you a little bit further down that road, which can help you with your understanding and definitely take care of all the requirements you may have if you're looking at the exam. But I also wanted to be able to give you material that would help you in real life as well, in whatever business you may be in as the security professional. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna start off by giving you the path on how to learn cryptography. And I said in a nutshell, it's pretty extensive. We're gonna have an extensive list of things for you to learn. Everything from, you know, what's a hash? How do we protect integrity? Why do we protect integrity? You know, how do we encrypt, decrypt? What are some of the different ways that we do this? All the way through things like public key infrastructure and PKI and how certificates work. So you're going to get all the information you need. And so I want to show you how to start off and just dive right in and get that taken care of. But I also, some people want to be able to kind of pick and choose some of the information that they might want to get to. So I also wanted to give you a breakdown of the common topics in the outline you might see for the CEH exam and point you to specific locations to get that information, just if you needed to brush up on something. And then I wanted to give you some guidance on what to do next after you've completed that. So let's get started with learning cryptography in a nutshell. When it comes to information security, the side of cryptography really focuses on the confidentiality side of protecting our data from unauthorized users seeing what that data is, and the integrity, making sure the data didn't get altered or changed without us knowing about it. And that's a very important part that a lot of people sometimes forget, and cryptography helps us with this. I mean, imagine somebody going in and changing payroll data. Now, of course, if they increased your salary, that's a good thing, but maybe they decreased your salary. That wouldn't be a good thing. Availability is something with risk management and high availability systems, making sure that the data is available to authorized users when they need it. That's not necessarily the focus of cryptography. It's mainly the confidentiality and integrity. So how do you start learning about cryptography? Well, here's what I did. Just recently, I shot a cryptography section in a different course. The course is called the SSCP. That's the Systems Security Certified Practitioner. And the SSCP cryptography course covers everything you need to know for cryptography, for ethical hacking. And the reason that I'm pointing you to this course is because in a lot of instances, I not only wanted you to be able to just meet exam criteria topics, but I also wanted you to have some real world information to help you deal with some of this, you know, when you're working at your job, when you're, you know, and I wanted you to be able to set up PKI, all of these topics that we want to get into. In a lot of cases, I gave you more information about it. And so I felt very important that rather than try to redo this or just do it for ethical hacking, that I'd rather send you to an entire great course that's already complete. Now, I do want to point out that the SSCP has seven courses in it total. And so you don't need to watch all of those. In fact, the ethical hacking courses that you've already been doing or that you're going to continue to do cover much more than in a lot of those cases. So just focus on the cryptography course. Now, there are a couple of topics in ethical hacking when we talk about cryptography that we also like to talk about, and that involves attacking and some of the ways to thwart those attacks or prevent those attacks from occurring. Now, for that information, I put that into a different SSCP course. It's the application security course, and that specifically is module 2. So here's how you learn the cryptography. Go watch the entire cryptography course for SSCP. Then stop by and watch the application security course module 2, and that'll talk about ways of different kinds of attacks, what they look like, and ways to prevent them. And then here's your third thing to do. When all's said and done, when you've done all of that, then come back to the next two modules. Because what I want to do is I want to add on a little bit additional information, and I want to give you some tools that you can work with cryptography for further study. And I think you'll find that really beneficial as well. Now, sometimes if you're somebody like me, sometimes it helps me to see the breakdown. And rather than just say, go watch that other course and you're going to be fine. Sometimes it helps to see how things are broken out. And so what I've done is I've taken the main topics of, if you're going after the CEH exam, the main topics in the cryptography section for the CEH, and I gave you directions on where you would find that particular information specifically. And this can be helpful if, you know, you're studying at some point, or, oh, what was that thing? And you want to see where directly to go. So think of this as kind of a mapping between the CEH and the information that I've recorded for SSCP. The first one is the cryptography concepts. And I have to say, this is one of the most important sections on starting to understand why cryptography is important and what some of the main components of it are. And you're going to find that in the SSCP cryptography course in module 2. Some of the other things that you're going to find very, very important, and they can be confusing, are some of the basics of encryption algorithms, which I also cover in module 2 of that SSCP cryptography course. Now, like all of the tools that you're going to see in this list, what I've done is I've talked about the tools in the third module in this course. That's under additional documentation. And after you've seen the cryptography course of SSCP, you'll come back here and I'll go through that documentation with you on some tools that you can work with to better further your education. Now, as you're working with cryptography in real life, one of the most important things is your public key infrastructure, or PKI. This is, it could be literally publicly cited, something that you might work with, like from Symmetric, used to be VeriSign, that kind of stuff, where you're getting certificates that you're going to use for the outside, or you may internally, most companies internally will have their own PKI infrastructure. It helps to understand how this works. And after you've learned the cryptography concepts and encryption algorithms, it'll make a lot more sense. So this is in SSCP's cryptography course, module 5. Now, I also spent a little bit of time talking about email encryption, which is in the module 4 course of the SSCP. And there's going to be times when you're going to want to encrypt things like files and disks and entire volumes. So I've got a bunch of tools for you in the additional documentation on disk encryption. Now, this is the one caveat to the SSCP crypto course that I mentioned, is when we talk about cryptography attacks, I actually did that in a different SSCP course, and that's the application security course. And that'll all be covered in module 2. And you'll learn about the different types of things that can attack, both scripting attacks and human-based attacks, and some of the things that we can do to prevent those. And then we have some cryptanalysis tools can be fun in both learning more about how cryptography works and even how to crack some of the old cryptography, so you can see both sides of the process of both protecting and attacking. And that I will also go through with you when we get to the additional documentation section. So this is kind of like a much more detailed breakdown list for you if you prefer this kind of list for your learning path. So after you've gone through all the cryptography material in the SSCP, is there anything else that you need to do? Yeah, there are a couple things. I wanted to add some more to this to give you some more benefit out of this. So first of all, in this course, module 2, the module after this one, is going to cover just a couple of extra topics. Some of them I mentioned in the SSCP cryptography course, but I just wanted to touch base with them again. A couple of them, they're brand new. And not that they're going to be necessarily on the exam or anything. It's just I want to make sure that I'm clear and that you had this additional information. Then after that, module 3 explains some of the added documentation that I've added for this course. And I think you can have a lot of fun furthering your education with this if you want to. We want to work with it. It's not required, but it's something that will help you move further. I gave you some additional material for further study, which is basically I gave you a list of tools that you can explore and work with and challenge yourself with and see what they do. And not it's not an exhaustive list of tools, but it's a pretty good list of tools for you to get started with. Then you can start exploring your on your own. It'll not only help you teach you more about cryptography and how things work, but also there's the attack and defense side of it too. And I also, there's an example in the SSCP that you will see where I'm using a hash calculator that I created. Well, I'm going to give you the code for that and show you how that looks again, just remind you of what it was, and then give you the code for that in case you want to play with that as well. So now it's time for you to go forth and start off learning the cryptography stuff and then come back to the next two modules. Here's what we did in this module. We talked about the learning path to learn the cryptography in a nutshell, as I call it. And this is basically going back to materials that I had just shot that I not only think will help you start to learn cryptography and certainly help you with if you're looking at the CEH exam, but also give you some more real life kind of directions to go in with some of this and to get working with cryptography. Now, if you're like me and you kind of need an additional breakdown, something that makes a little bit more sense or a little bit more targeted, I gave you a breakdown of the outline, basically the outline that CEH gives you for the crypto course, the top topics that they have and where they map into the SSCP just to help remove any confusion that might pop up along the way. And then when you're done with that, like I said, what to do next, come on back here and go to the next two modules. The next module that we're going to do is going to start off with going through some additional topics that I just wanted to make sure I got a chance to touch on, kind of refresh some of those. And then the third and last module in this course will get you some additional tools to further your education. So coming up next in the next module, let's look at some additional tools. But first, make sure you go check out the SSCP cryptography. Then come back and we'll look at some additional topics.